It's been awful and dusty for the most part, but the air here is nice and clear. Do you see that? The air is so clear here, fish even swim in it. That's actually quite odd now that I think about it. Looks like we've found our first memory in this area. Oh my! This looks like a katana. Maybe we'll hear a story about a samurai. Let's have a look, shall we?
A man sits alone. Though he speaks, the target of his words is unseen. To this invisible listener, he offers praise for a task well handled. His eyes narrow. He hesitates. Then, his voice a rasp, he murmurs an instruction. On to the next. The target of his words is revealed behind the scrim of a dividing wall. She also sits alone. In her hand rests a small scroll adorned with a face. Slipping the scroll into the folds of her robe, she stands and makes her response. Understood. An ominous sky. The castle town bustles as people move to and fro. A family traveling the road catches her eye. The child smiles brightly, her eyes sparkling. The darkness of the woman's own life could never know such pleasant light. Brushing aside her melancholy, she makes to leave town. Of silver catches the woman's eye as an assassin appears before her. A thin razor of a smile crosses her face. She knows this is exactly where she belongs. She claims the assassin's life before body can meet Earth. In the silence that follows, she muses on her life. She walks a path of blood, a solitary path, far from family or comfort. Had she ever smiled as that child did? Could she? Such thoughts swirl in her mind as the woman considers a life she knows she will never have.
It seems this tale involves a female assassin. I wonder what the secret to her strength is. Just want to slow our progress, or is there some deeper goal? Sometimes I wonder what those dark foes are trying to accomplish. A large gate. We certainly won't be able to lift this on our own. What a good eye you have. Here, let Mama take care of that for you. There now. That wasn't so hard. A collapsed bridge? Oh dear. The Scarecrow is so close. There must be a way to get past this. Wait here, child. Mama will take a quick peek around. This is a bother. Who even lowered the water in the first place? I do wish these levers weren't quite so heavy. Right then. One down and three to go. Going quite well so far. I just hope those two find happiness. Wonderful. That did the trick. Now we can cross to the other side. That certainly did take a lot of time. Well, let's get back on our feet and continue with the restoration, shall we?
The girl stirs from a thin sleep, her features weary as a woman thrice her years. Her life is an unending blur of training that continues without mercy or pause. Bones creak, flesh stings. Pain is her constant companion. Yet she forces herself down the hall all the same. When she arrives at the garden, a bellowing roar orders her forward. "Coming," she replies in a voice devoid of all feeling. She readies an apology for her tardiness, knowing full well it will not be heard. As suspected, the man cuts off her words and begins to berate her without pause. You will learn to honor punctuality, girl. You are a tool of our master, and a tool is of no use if it is not present when needed. Thus begins another day of the girl's deadly training.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
There.
Here we go.
How annoying. Her family has served their lord's clan for generations. When the lord decides an enemy needs to die, her family carries out the sentence. Her path had been laid before she was even born. The path of a trained killer. There is no freedom for her. No thought of a different way. The path simply was. The woman does not bemoan her fate, for she has never known another. Yet, when she thinks of the things she will never have, she feels a terrible sadness. But she presses on regardless, leaving such distractions behind. At some point, she realizes that rain has begun to fall. Through the droplets, she spies a castle with a dark and enigmatic aura. Soon she finds a lone guard standing before a gate, moving without sound. She looses her sword. With death delivered, she sheathes her blade and presses on.
Her whole life had been decided before she was even born. It's rather a tragedy, don't you think? I'm sure you must. must have a birthplace as well. A place you...
You should leave before I change my mind.
I have no time for this.
How annoying.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
Need some help. How annoying.
Thanks. Do you hear that? That's... It escaped again. What's that sound? Spiders make music when you step on them. Do you think that monster was playing the steps? That's a rather cute thing to do, don't you think?
The woman moves ever deeper into the castle in search of her target. Her mission is to kill the son of an enemy lord and halt his possible succession. The enemy army values blood. If the successor were to die, chaos will inevitably follow. Slaying the sun will create confusion, giving her own lord an opening for attack. She passes through the corridors and moves toward a reception room. Outside, the rain falls in endless gray sheets. A child sits alone, his frame made smaller by the size of the room. She recognizes the boy's face from her scroll. Without a word, she draws her sword and points the tip at the child's throat. Yet he simply stares at the cold steel, making no move to escape. As the woman studies the child's haggard face, she realizes something. This is no son of a lord, but instead a girl frocked in boy's clothing. The woman asks her target why this is. As if a dam has burst, the girl suddenly lets fly with a torrent of grievance. I wish this house and this entire nation would fall. Thank you.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
Come. The girl begins to tell her tale. I am not but a puppet who dances at my father's tomb. I'm no child to him, merely a tool to be used. I even denied my own heart and took false gender in order to fulfill my role. And as this house's tool, I live only to be killed. So please, just bring this to pass. End me. The girl's eyes turn to rest on the woman. This is who I used to be. Set to walk a path before I had even drawn breath. The woman's sword wavers. Her hand hesitates. Outside, the rain falls as if it was trying to blot out the very earth itself. And yet somehow, it feels quiet.
The next memory should be the last one in this area. I wonder what that monster wants, and those other dark foes for that matter. I'll cut down everything in my way.
I won't pull back.
Nier.
You!
How annoying.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
Come. How annoying.
I think the last scarecrow in this area is inside this building. Oh my! Again! What terrible timing these things have. Mama will open this straight away. Get through now? This next memory should restore the weapon. The scarecrow is right there. brave faces now.
The only sound is the rain. A long moment passes. The woman sheathes her blade. She then asks the bewildered girl, "Did you mean it when you said you wish your house would fall?" Shaking, the girl nods. The woman responds, "Understood." Suddenly, the sounds of an army clattering into place emerge behind them. A score of soldiers bursts into the reception room. The woman's face is the very picture of composure. "Come then," she whispers.
I shall take care of them.
Watch over me.
Do it. The girl runs over and takes her hand. Why had she done this? The sound of the rain begins to fade. People cannot choose the station of their birth. One can scarcely even choose their own manner of death in this violent, fleeting world. But perhaps one can choose to let another live. I was a tool of my house who carried out her role. My hands are stained with sins beyond counting. I doubt this will absolve me of my actions. But it might make a nice gift to bring with me into hell. She can no longer hear the rain. Tears roll down the girl's cheeks. And on the woman's face is something almost like a smile.
Perhaps freedom, in the truest meaning of the word, never existed to begin with. We are bound by heavy chains, which closes many doors, and one often lacks the will to choose from the remaining options. Anger. This is the fourth fragment that you've lost. What is your anger meant for? Is it for a person? The world? Your fate? Or perhaps yourself? The time when you will also have to choose draws nearer.